Everybody loves a blurry background, but how do you go about getting that blurry background? What's going on YouTube? My name is Wyatt, and today we're going to be talking about how to blur the background in your photos and videos. Real quick, I do want to say that whenever you are referring to a blurry background in the professional world, you refer to it as shallow depth of field. So if you hear me use that term anytime throughout this video, I'm just referring to the blurriness of the background. The first thing you're going to do is you are going to grab your smartphone, open up the camera, and go to portrait mode, and boom, you're done. Blurry backgrounds for everybody. Jokes aside, those smartphones are pretty amazing in terms of what they can do with blurring out backgrounds and the AI software and stuff that they use to do that. It just works a little bit differently than what we're going to be talking about today, which is how to blur the background if you own a mirrorless DSLR interchangeable lens camera. Some of these tips will apply to your smartphone camera with some limitations. So in all seriousness, the first thing that we are going to talk about is your aperture. So for those of you who don't know, your aperture is basically how wide your lens is able to open up, and the wider that the lens opens up, the more light that comes into the lens to create your image. I'd be lying if I said I know exactly how this affects the blurriness of your background, but just know that in general, the lower your aperture is, then the more blur you're going to get into your background. Now, obviously, the lowest aperture that your lens can open up to depends on the lens that you have. The specific lens that I'm shooting this video on goes all the way down to f1.4, which is what we're shooting this video at. That's how come I have these nice little bokeh balls and a nice blur to my background, and it's not completely in focus. My kit lens has a minimum aperture of f3.5, and that's only whenever the lens is at its widest point at 15 millimeters. If I zoom all the way into 45 millimeters, which is as far as my lens can reach, then my minimum aperture goes all the way up to 6.3. Like I was saying, the lower the number of your aperture, the more background blur you're going to have. So in my personal opinion, an aperture of around 2.8 is kind of a good starting point to start to introduce some real nice blur. Anything higher than that, you can still get some blur in your images, and we'll go over how to here soon, but it's just not going to be as organic as it is if you have an aperture that opens up wider. Generally, lenses that do open up to a wider aperture are going to be more expensive. If I had to make one recommendation, I would recommend the Canon Nifty 50. This lens opens all the way up to 1.8, which is nice and wide. It lets in a lot of light. If you're going to be shooting in low light conditions, it's a plus for that. But if you are simply just trying to get an out of focus, nice blurry background, this is going to do a great job of it. Whether you're taking portraits, product photography, whatever the case may be, this does a great job. Plus, if you are shooting on the Canon M50 or any of Canon's other mirrorless system, you can pick up this Viltrox speed booster. And what that does is it actually lets in more light. It's kind of like a magnifying glass for the lens. So in my camera settings, it actually lets me bring the aperture all the way down to f1.2, making it faster than the Sigma 16 millimeter that I'm filming this video on. And whenever I say fast, I'm referring to a lens that has a low aperture, because in photography, you can raise your shutter speed up higher, making your shutter faster the more light that's let into the camera. So if you ever hear me say fast lens, that's why. If you don't own a faster lens, then don't worry, because there are still ways that you can get blur into the background of your photos and videos. Which brings me to my second point, and that is distance. So whenever I say distance, I'm not just referring to the distance between your camera and the subject. I'm also referring to the distance between your subject and the background. In general, the closer your subject is to the camera, the more background blur you're going to have. And if you can separate your subject from the background, giving more distance between that, you can also get more background blur that way. These are some test images that I shot. I took one of them up close and then I took one of them further away and using the same exact settings and at relatively higher aperture. As you can see, in the photo that I'm closer to the subject, there is more background blur than the photo that I'm further away. Now, obviously, if I'm able to drop my aperture all the way down to f1.4, you get something that looks like this. And that's going to give you the most amount of background blur that you can get. But as you can see, if I am able to move closer to my subject, then I am able to introduce a little bit more background blur than what I would if I'm further away. Now, obviously, you don't want to change the distance from your subject so much that it affects the composition of the photo and your framing doesn't make any sense. But if you are able to get closer to your subject with your camera, and you do want a blurry background, that is going to help. And my last piece of advice for you, if you want to have smooth, creamy, blurry backgrounds, is to look at longer focal lengths. Now, whenever I say longer focal length, that is the millimeters of your lens. The longest focal length that I personally have is a 50 millimeter. The lens I'm using to film this video is a 16 millimeter, so it's a lot wider than what this lens is. However, lenses go all the way up to like 800 millimeters. Thankfully, my dad does own a 70 to 300 millimeter, and I was able to borrow it over the weekend, and I was able to take a couple of test images so you guys can see what I'm talking about. So this is called compression in the lens. Again, I really don't know the mathematics or the science behind why you get compression when shooting at a longer focal length, but that's not really important. The only thing that you and I need to know is that if we shoot at longer focal lengths, then we are going to get a more compressed background, giving it that blurry effect. In both of these photos, I am doing the complete opposite of what I told you to do in the first two steps. My aperture is super high, and I'm about 10 to 15 feet away from the subject because my framing wouldn't make sense if I was close up on my subject. However, with those two things pushed to the side, we still have a nice blurry background because of the compression of the lens. Again, don't know why. I kind of care because it's pretty interesting. If you know, please let me know down in the comments. I would love to find out how this compression thing really works. But like I said, the only thing that you and I need to know at the moment is that if you have a lens that shoots at a longer focal length and you do want to get more blur to your background, that's a great way to do it. And that's really about all, guys. I want to keep this video nice and short just because you don't need to put too much thought into it. It doesn't take that much to blur your background. Like I said, in my personal opinion, the fastest way to do this is to go buy a faster lens that has a lower aperture than what you currently own. That's going to give you the quickest results right off the bat. But feel free to practice around with the tips such as getting closer to your subject and having more distance in the background. Going back to tips that you can apply to your smartphone camera, that is one of them. Even with my smartphone camera without using portrait mode, if I get close up on a subject and there is a decent amount of space between the subject and the background, I'm still able to get some nice background blur, even though I'm not able to adjust things like my aperture or shoot at 200 millimeters. That about is it for the video, guys. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, please be sure to leave it a like. I will be coming out with a video next week. And YouTube, until the next one, I'll see you later.